A 14-year-old girl has had a sore throat for 4 days now with no improvement. She's not sneezing or coughing. She has had a fever the entire time, around 38 degrees Celsius. She is a bit tired, but otherwise in a good clinical condition. The doctor examines her throat and it looks something like this. Swollen tonsils with a lot of exudate, and her lymph nodes in the neck are quite swollen as well. With no cough, with exudate on the tonsils, enlarged nodes, and a temperature around 38 degrees Celsius, and her age, her center score is very high, the highest possible. Therefore, the doctor should probably do a throat swab to see if this is strep throat. Her pre-test probability is quite high, isn't it? The only problem, however, is that it's Friday night and the doctor's office is in a small town in Croatia and it's not very well equipped, to put it mildly. Rapid strep tests are pure science fiction here, and as for bacterial culture, the nearest microbiological lab is 20 kilometers away and it only opens on Monday. My question is, what should the doctor do? Prescribe antibiotics for suspected strep throat right away, or wait until Monday to send the throat swab for culture and then wait a day or two until it's completed before making the final decision? Feel free to pause and think. Well, it's good to keep in mind that even the highest center score translates only into about 50% chance that this is really strep throat. Besides, there is a very common and very convincing copycat to worry about here. Infectious mononucleosis, a viral infection caused by EBV, which can mimic strep throat in almost every way and present with a very high center score. I would certainly worry about that here, especially since the patient is a teenager, which is the typical age for mono. I would closely examine the nodes in her neck, because in strep throat, typically the anterior nodes will be swollen and painful, but in mono, nodes in all regions of the neck will be enlarged, including those behind the sternoclavicomastoid muscle. You won't find that in strep throat. I would also examine the abdomen to see if the spleen or the liver is enlarged. This would also speak against strep throat and more for mono. And let's hope that the doctor at least has access to a CBC. In mono, after 4 days, there should be clear lymphocytosis, at least relative lymphocytosis, whereas in strep throat, there should be neutrophilia. In the absence of more sophisticated diagnostic methods, even our everyday CBC with differential should help. Anyway, if the patient looks well and there are no signs of serious illness, I will probably withhold treatment and reevaluate in a couple of days. Starting antibiotics immediately is also reasonable here, as long as there are no signs of mono, but the point is that this isn't an emergency. There are no signs of complications right now, and in Croatia, as in most of Europe, rheumatic fever is extremely uncommon, so it's not something I would worry about here. Besides, in order to minimize the probability of rheumatic fever, it's enough to start treatment with antibiotic for strep throat within 9 days of the onset of symptoms. So, even if you are worried about rheumatic fever, there is plenty of time. Not to mention that patients with mono who mistakenly receive antibiotics often end up with a nasty generalized rash, the amoxicillin rash, right? Why put them through that if there is no need? In conclusion, if your patient with pharyngitis is well and shows no signs of complications, don't rush to antibiotics. You have plenty of time to order additional tests if you want to, but remember that pharyngitis is almost always self-limited. It will almost always go away after a couple of days, even without treatment, even if it's strep throat. Remember that even the highest center score doesn't mean that this is 100% strep throat, not even close. Mono is a very convincing copycat, and you can use the signs I mentioned here to differentiate between the two. And if you want a detailed, in-depth approach to the treatment of the most common and most severe infections, take a look at the list of lectures in my course, Antibiotics in Clinical Practice. I hope to see you there. Take care.